Hello, my name is Benjamin Hart. I'm an American attorney and the managing director of Integrity Legal here in Bangkok, Thailand. As the title of this film suggests, we're going to be discussing social media in the context of the K-1 fiancé visa. I've had some questions here recently, especially with the promulgation or the proposed promulgation of rules related to requesting social media information from applicants for U.S. visas to the United States. And some more general questions just regarding social media as a whole. The first question generally comes as, do I think that they're ultimately going to be seeking social media information? Yeah, I do. I do think that eventually officers or the State Department or whoever is adjudicating visa applications in the relatively near future are going to want information pertaining to one's social media accounts. What they're going to do with that information remains to be seen. The next question I often get is, well, can they use that information now? The short answer is probably. In fact, consular officers adjudicating the factual situation of a given case associated with immigration benefits abroad have a pretty wide discretion. And pursuant to the doctrine of consular absolutism or consular non-reviewability, which we did a video specifically on this channel, those individuals, those consular officers, their factual determinations are basically unreviewable. So if they make a factual determination regarding the, for example, what they believe to be the genuineness of a marriage or a proposed marriage, that factual finding is pretty difficult to refute, if it's refutable at all. And for this reason, I don't think it's outside the realm of possibility that consular officers will use social media information where it is warranted. Let me give a few examples. I have actually seen consular officers physically travel to places where issues, this is mostly in issues involving waivers, where, you know, the issue that pertained to the waiver was stipulated in a given case, and the consular officer actually went to the location where that activity was stipulated to have taken place in order to ascertain whether or not that establishment was in fact engaging in the activities that were being stipulated to. I have seen fraud prevention unit officers go to fairly great lengths to ascertain the genuineness in a given relationship. So the reason I bring this up is, in a way, this social media stuff kind of brings the information to them, if you will. And where there's clearly, you know, you say, you know, I can use a hypothetical here where an individual going into the interview for, say, a K-1 visa, you know, they say that they're with their partner and they're very committed to their partner, even though they're separated by a long distance. But then if the consular officer, you know, ascertains that individual's Facebook account, say, and there are tons of videos from the week prior or photos, for example, from the week prior to the interview of that individual, you know, romantically involved or what appears to be romantically involved with another individual, that's not going to augur well for that interview. That's not going to augur well for the final decision in that adjudication. So the short answer with respect to social media is, can they use that information? Yeah. If they can find out what that individual's social media, how to access their social media information. Moreover, I think in the relatively near future, as we've discussed in a video on this channel previously, I think in the relatively near future, we're going to actually see them require social media account information, and you're probably going to see officers reviewing those accounts in order to ascertain the genuineness of an underlying proposed marriage.